After debate at the Ohio State House, a committee cleared the way for Goddard's law with a unanimous vote last week. House Bill 274 is going before the House of Representatives, and it will happen on Wednesday with Dick Goddard watching.
Everyone who had anything to do with this needs to be congratulated. We're not quite there, but we're close.
Goddard's law would redefine companion animal abuse in Ohio, one of a few states without felony provisions for extreme cases of abuse that some say are all too common.
Well, we always see situations that we don't like.
Dr. Paul Bucks, a veterinarian in Minerva, where he's caring for a cat with serious injuries after an unknown person shot the animal.
We know that the pellet had to have been there a while, or she had previous trauma. We're not sure because the hips are, or her pelvis is fractured.
It went in and it fractured her hip. And so she has kind of a little bit of hip problems, and then it came through and it's lodged in the side of her skin.
Nicole Ake found the cat. Now she plans to keep her after yet another surgery.
It's very, very upsetting that anybody could even think about doing any kind of harm to any kind of animal. I mean, animals, they don't do anything to us.
While Goddard's law would redefine companion animal abuse here in the state of Ohio, that change would be primarily in larger communities, big cities. Farming communities and more rural neighborhoods would be exempt.
We're very rural out here. You've got farmers, they've got livestock to protect. It's easy to get mad at somebody over something we consider abuse, but they're looking at their livelihoods.
If it clears the House on Wednesday, the fight shifts to the Senate, where its passage would almost guarantee Goddard's law would become the law.
I think it's a great idea. I think it's fantastic. Too many animals are abandoned, are hurt, are harmed, and for Dick Goddard to try and pass this law, if telling her story can help pass this law, I will tell the story to the world.
In Minerva, Mark Zinni, Fox 8 News.